Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Amir Hussain and you are watching
Trick I Know YouTube channel.
I am back again with an exciting video. In this video, I am going to install an external graphic card on Lattepanda Alpha. Yes, guys, this is a complete step-by-step tutorial about how to install eGPU on Lattepanda Alpha. So without wasting any time, guys, let's get into the video.
So guys, here is my Lattepanda Alpha with my 22-inch Full HD IPS monitor. In my last video, I tested the gaming performance of Lattepanda Alpha without the eGPU. Now this time, let's have a look of the desktop. I am recording this screen using a screen recorder, and here are the games which I tested in my previous video. All these games are installed in a M.2 NVMe SSD drive. You can check both the gaming and the SSD video from the link in the description. And as we know, Lattepanda Alpha comes with Intel M3 processor with 8GB RAM and with the Intel HD 615 graphics processor, which is not good enough to play modern games. So guys, now I am going to install a desktop external graphic card on this Lattepanda Alpha. As a eGPU adapter, I am using a NGFF version Exp GDC graphic card dock. It comes with a power connector and a NGFF version eGPU cable. You can buy this Exp GDC graphic card dock from banggood.com. Just check out the link in the video description. Step number 1. Turn on or restart your Lattepanda Alpha. Then in the logo screen, press escape key to open the BIOS setup. In the BIOS setting, all you have to do, just go to the chipset tab, go to graphics configuration, and here you can see primary display is set to auto. You have to change it to the SG mode. This is mandatory to use eGPU on the Lattepanda Alpha. If you don't do this, you will get a blank screen like this. Now save the settings by pressing F4 on your keyboard. Now disconnect the power cable and the HDMI cable from the board. Step number 2, guys. Take out the eGPU cable given with the dock. Plug that cable into the M.2 eKey slot on the Lattepanda Alpha. Unfortunately, this cable is not made for this board, so there is not any mount for this cable. You have to do some DIY stuffs here. In my idea, the double-sided foam tape is going to work here. Just cut a small piece of tape and paste the foam tape near the M.2 slot. Now remove the upper peel from the tape. Then plug the eGPU cable on M.2 slot and paste it on the foam tape. Now it's not going to unplug easily, guys. If you have any better idea, you can do that. So our eGPU cable is connected to the Lattepanda Alpha. Now move over to the step number 3. To power up the dock and the graphic card, you will need a PSU like this. It's a Corsair 450 watt VS series PSU. To run just a graphic card, it is enough. Just take out the PSU from the box. Then separate the 24 pin power connector, 6 pin PCIe connector and 4 pin CPU connector from it. Wind the extra wires because we don't need them in this setup. Now take out the power connector given with the eGPU dock. Connect it with the 24 pin power connector from the PSU. Connect the 4 pin CPU connector like this. So here our power setup is ready. Make sure green wire is to green, yellow to yellow and black to black. Step number 4. Take out your eGPU dock. Then plug the 8 pin power connector from the PSU. You can see, guys, it's coming from the PSU. Now plug the eGPU cable from the Lattepanda Alpha, just like this. Here our dock setup is complete. Now it's time to plug the graphic card on the dock which you have selected. Just plug it like this. In my graphic card, there is 6-pin supplementary power connector is needed. So I'm going to plug it right here. So guys, our eGPU setup is almost completed. Make sure the Lattepanda power supply is connected. Your monitor is turned on. Power up your PSU. Now here, the game is going to be changed. The HDMI cable from the monitor is now going to connect it to the graphic card, because this card is now our primary output. So guys, finally all hardware setup is completed. Now it's time to turn on our beast. The graphic card will turn on automatically by turning on the Lattepanda Alpha, and also it will turn off with the shutdown. So our PC is started, guys. Now right click on my computer and go to properties. Then go to device manager. Under the display adapters, now you can see there are two display adapters. The graphic card is detected as Microsoft basic display adapter because the driver is not installed. Now next, open your web browser and search Nvidia. Go to the Nvidia website and download the driver. So I have Asus ROG series GeForce GTX 1650 graphic card. So the model is GeForce and series is 16 and it's a GTX 1650. So you can search your graphic card driver like this. Now my graphic card driver is downloaded and now I'm going to install this. Now here you have to agree and continue. Hit next. In few minutes your graphic card driver will be installed. Now you can see guys, in the device manager, basic driver is changed to GeForce GTX 1650. After the driver installation, restart your Lattepanda Alpha to apply the driver changes properly. The setup is completed guys. Now it's time to play the games. Starting with the GTA 5. But before I start, I want to mention that I am playing this game with my wireless keyboard and mouse. And let me show you the graphics settings. I am playing this game in 720p resolution and in almost very high settings. The game movement is very smooth guys. There is not any issues. Hitting very nice FPS here. It's crossing over the 90 FPS. I don't like this.
Dear Lord, are you all right?
It's just a bug, sweetheart, you ain't sure.
Let's play a old game, Devil May Cry. You can see I am playing the game in 1080p resolution and in the ultra settings.
Oh,
Now here I am testing Crysis 3, and here is the graphics setting, playing in 1080p resolution and in very high graphics quality.
Okay, this is how it's gonna work. I'll call out the locations as I see them, like this one in Sector 1 Delta 0. These are potential cache locations. Our primary target is Tower 3 Delta 3. As soon as you get the hardware, we'll knock the bastard out cold. Sector 1 Delta 3, looks good. There, Sector 1 Delta 0.
Shadow of the Tomb Raider, I don't know how to pronounce it. Here I am playing it in high settings in 720p resolution. This game is also running smoothly without any issues. You can see it, guys.
Storm's getting closer. We have a couple hours at most.
Here is a quick benchmark of this game. It's hitting around 100 FPS. 50 FPS here. And here are the final results. Here is Fortnite. Let's see how it's running. Fast movement in menu. Let's play a emote. Nice. And the settings are, quality is set to high. 120 FPS fixed and 1080p resolution. You can see it's running smooth in 1080p settings. And here is the short gameplay. The FPS is hitting up to 70 FPS. Very nice. Now guys, I'm going to play PUBG Lite. Here are the settings. I'm playing this game in full 1080p resolution and overall graphics quality is set to high. FPS is hitting over 130 FPS. This game is also running very smooth in 144 FPS, guys. Very fast and smooth movement, guys. So you can do better gaming on Lattepanda Alpha by adding a better graphic card, a PSU and a Exp GDC graphic card dock. Check out the video description for the link of these items.
So that was my video on how to set up eGPU on Lattepanda Alpha. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you really enjoyed, hit that like button. And if you are new to my channel, make sure to subscribe my channel with the bell icon for more videos updates like this. Share my video with your friends and family, guys. And if you have any questions regarding this project, leave a comment below. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you in my next video.